Welcome to Words of Power. Today's message is about Genesis 3, and this is the third part in this series. Today we're talking about feeling limited. When you were a kid, did you ever feel like your parents were limiting you unfairly? Perhaps you wanted to go hang out with a friend, and they thought that friend was bad for you. Maybe they told you not to go out late at night because it was dangerous. We may feel that God is limiting us unfairly, but as with our natural parents, God loves us and wants the best for us. He leads us in the right direction so we can be successful. We must listen and obey His instructions. In Genesis 2, God has made the heavens and the earth. Adam and Eve are living together as a family. In Genesis 3, the serpent decides to tempt Eve by encouraging her to doubt God. To tempt someone means to attract them or lure them to do something wrong by promising them pleasure or gain. As you recall from Genesis 3 and 1, Satan poses a question to Eve that suggests that God is limiting them. Did God really say you must not eat from any tree in the garden? Satan's question is posed as if God forbid Adam and Eve from eating from all the trees. This attempts to make God seem unfair or overly restrictive. In reality, we learned in Genesis 2:16 through 17 that Adam, and by extension Eve, could eat from all of the trees in the garden except for one tree, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And why was that? Because they would certainly die if they ate from that tree. Do you see how the enemy twisted God's command in Genesis 3 and 1 to deceive Eve and make her think twice about God's goodness? When you are talking to your kids or small group, think about these questions. Are you hearing something that suggests that God is not good? This is not from God. Consider these scenarios. There was a party that you were considering going to, but you didn't have a good feeling about it. You decided to tell your friends that you're going to stay home. One of your friends messages you and says, "Why can't you go to any parties? You never get to go anywhere fun." In reality, you just went with friends to hang out last week and had a great time. You didn't feel led to go to the party, so you said no. But now you're beginning to feel like you can't go to anything fun with friends. Consider scenario 2. Your friends invited you to a sleepover, but it was the same night as church. So your parents suggested going to church instead. You wanted to do that anyway so you could learn and see your friends at church. The next day, your friends who went to the sleepover say, "Why are you always at church? Missing one day is not that big of a deal." You felt like your parents were pretty open, but now you're not so sure. You begin to think that God doesn't want you to have fun unless it's at church. It's important to know what is the truth so we can refute the lies of the enemy or our own thoughts that aren't true. Things that we think or hear that are often untrue about ourselves use the words always and never. These are absolutes. For example, "I can never go anywhere." Well, this cannot be true because you are allowed to go to some places. What is the truth? Let's go to the Bible and see what it says. Psalm 84 and 11, ESV version says this, "For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord bestows favor and honor. No good thing does He withhold from them who walk uprightly." This verse means that God is a shield to us. He protects us from harm and provides light in a dark world. If we walk God's way, He will not keep any good thing from us. No matter what our circumstances are outwardly, we can trust in God and have joy. What about Hebrews 10:35? The New King James Version says, "Therefore, do not cast away your confidence, which has great reward." Psalm 145:9 in the NIV version says, "The Lord is good to all, and His mercy is over all that He has made." God is good. He has many promises for us. As believers in Jesus Christ, we can have confidence in God and His goodness. By listening to God and following His commandments, we not only have positive rewards, but also avoid the consequences of sin. We will still have trials in this life, but with God, we overcome them all.